हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल लाइफ लॉन्ग लर्निंग विद माया। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेरी गुड इन योर स्टडीज़ एंड लेट अस सी द टुडेज़ टॉपिक दैट इज़ डिविजिबिलिटी टेस्ट ऑफ 7, 8, 11। द लास्ट वीडियो वॉज अगेन ऑन द सेम टॉपिक बट ऑफ डिफरेंट नंबर्स, सो इफ़ यू वॉन्ट यू कैन जस्ट गो एंड चेक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स एंड यू कैन गो चेक विद दैट लिंक to see the previous video of the same divisibility test on different numbers, that is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9 and 10. So that was different, this is different video, so we can just continue with it. Now to check the divisibility test of 7, have to do, let us start understanding with an example. So if I take an example 1, that is 392. This is our first example. And in for the divisibility test of 2, what we have to do is we have to check the last digit, double it. Okay, so this is the last digit, the ones place here, so we have to double it. 2 times 2, luckily it is 2 only, so 2 times 2 is 4, and we have to subtract that last digit, the double of the last digit, with the rest of the numbers, that is 39. So 39 minus 4, so what will be the answer? 35. Now the result should be the multiple of 7. Okay, either it should be 0 or multiple of 7. Here in this case we have 35. 35 is divisible by 7, right? 7 times 5 is 35, so it is divisible by 7, therefore the whole number is divisible by 7. I hope you got it. Let us see one more example for the same. The next question we will take is 2394. Now here also this is a number. What we have to do, the last digit we have to take it and double it, so 4 times 2, so 4 times 2 is what? 8. Now we have to subtract 8 by rest of the numbers, that is 239. Now when we subtract 239 by 8, like 8, when we subtract 8 by 239, what is the result? Is 231. Okay, 231. Now we don't know whether 231 is divisible by 7 or not, so we can just follow the same method again. We will the same thing, double of the last digit, that is 1 times 2 and then subtracted by 23. So 23 minus 2 is 21. So we can see that the result here is 21, which is divisible by 7. 7 times 3 is 21. So therefore 21 is divisible by 7, so the whole number is divisible by 7. I hope you got it. So divisibility test of 7 is quite simple. We have to just keep checking, like doubling the last digit and then subtracting it with the rest of the numbers, and if the number is greater, we can again continue with the same process and find out until we find the whether the end number, whatever, until we understand that the last digit is divisible by 7. So therefore we know that the whole number will be divisible by 7. Now let us move on to the next number, that is divisibility test of 8. Now if you remember, for 4 and 8 is quite similar. In for divisibility test of 4, it was required that the last two digits should be divisible by 4 or it should be 00. The last two digits either should be 00 or it should be divisible by 4. Now in the for divisibility test of 8, the last three digits should be divisible by 8 or it should be 3 zeros at the end. Okay, so either so this is the criteria for divisibility test of 8. Now here it is not 3 zeros at the end, but the last 3 digit, we can see that 480, that is 48, is divisible by 8. So if 48 is divisible by 8, 480 is also divisible by 8. So yes, this is divisible by 8. Let us see another example for the same, for divisibility test of 8. 1728. Now again here we will see the last three digit. Now in this case also it is not 000, last three digit. If any number has the like digit like 1728 and then last three digits are 0, definitely this whole number will be divisible by 8 because the last three digit here is 000. But we are not looking at this question, we are looking at this question where it is not 00. So let us find out whether these 728 is divisible by 8 or not. So what is the easiest way to check whether the last three digit is divisible by 8 or not, we have to divide it. Okay, 728 divided by 8. We have to divide it and check. So 728 divided by 8 will be 8 times 9 is 72. 8 will come down. So 8 times 1. 8 ones are 8. So the remainder is 0. So whenever the remainder comes 0, that means this number is divisible by 8. So therefore the last three digit is divisible by 8. So the whole number is divisible by 8. I hope this is also clear to you. Let us see the divisibility test for 11. It will be little different from like all the method. First example, that is 3619. Okay, 3619. Let us take a small example first. Number at the odd place and number at the even place. Now this is if we consider first digit, like generally we always talk from the last digit. So last digit is the first place, that is one at number one position, which is an odd position, right? Number one. Then this is second position. The third one is again odd. This is also at odd position. Now here this number two, like one, this is at the second place, so it is even position, and this number is again at the even position. So here we can see that we have found out the numbers at the even position and the numbers at the odd position. So what exactly we will do, we have to add them all, like odd positions number has to be added, even position number has to be added, and we have to find the difference of them. Okay, the odd places, so 6 plus 9, and number at the even places, that is 3 plus 1. So 6 plus 9 is 6 plus 6 is 12, 13, 14, 15. So this is 15, and 3 plus 1 is 4. Now what we have to do after adding the like numbers at the odd places and number at the even places, we should find the difference of it. So difference is bigger minus the smaller. Difference is 11. So either the difference should be anything multiple of 11. It's not necessary that it should be 11. It can be 22, 33, 44, 55. Any number which is divisible by 11. Okay. Or it can be 0 also. If the difference is 0 or divisible, any number which is divisible by 11, then the whole number is divisible by 11. So that is that simple. Okay, so now here comes 11, so that 3619 is divisible by 11. Okay, now let us see one more example. So now the second example we will take for 11 only is 38016. Okay, again here we will first figure out which one is our odd the numbers at the odd places and the numbers at the even places. So let us find out this. We start from the last digit, this number, and then 0 and then 3. These are the three numbers at the odd places. Okay, and these two numbers are the numbers at the even places. This is second position and fourth position. This is first position, third position, and fifth position. So therefore we know how to find out the odd positions, the number at the odd positions and number at the even positions. Okay, we are adding 3 plus 0 plus 6. Okay, number at the odd position is 6, 0 and 3. So we are adding 3 plus 0 plus 6. That will give us 9. Sorry, it will give us 9. And then we will have to add the number at the even position, that is 8 plus 1, which is again going to give us 9. Now we know that both the number at the odd position is also 9 and number at the even position is also 9. So we will have to find the difference of it. We know 9 minus 9 is 0. So the difference is 0. Therefore, we know that whenever the difference is either 0 or any number divisible by 11. So if it is that way, it is the whole number is divisible by 11. So that I hope this is also clear to all of you. So this was all, and the divisibility test of 7, I hope you remember that how we have to double the last digit and find out the difference of the rest of the number with the last digit after doubling, and then if the remainder is 0 or divisible by 7, then the whole number is divisible by 7. For 8, last 3 digits should be either 0 or last 3 digits should be divisible by 8. If we don't know whether it is divisible, we can divide it and check the remainder should be 0. Then the whole number is divisible by 8. And for 11, it is that we have to subtract the sum of the odd position numbers to the sum of even position numbers. We can see that which one is greater, we have to subtract the smaller from the greater number, and the result should be either 0 or multiple of 11. So therefore, I hope that you have understood. And if you have any question, please ask me in the comment section. And I really appreciate my followers, those who are my subscribers, those who are subscribed my channel. And I really wish to make a lot of good videos for you all about math. So please comment me in the comment section if you have any particular doubt or any particular topic to be covered. Thank you so much for watching me. Thanks. Bye.